Hello student, my name is Bijendra Kumar Patel and today I will discuss the solution of caste subject physics. And the caste is exam is conducted by the CLC and the full form of caste is CLC admission cum scholarship test. So the first question is, the radius of curvature of a spherical mirror is 20 centimeter. What is its focal length? So we know the formula of focus F equal to R by 2, where R is the radius of curvature of spherical mirror. So the radius is given 20 centimeter. So F will be equal to 10 centimeter. So the correct answer is first option is correct. Next question is, a person standing in front of a mirror finds his image larger than himself. This implies that the mirror. So the question is, we have to find the which mirror can make the image larger than himself, and a person can see the image of himself if the image is real. So the correct answer will be concave, because concave mirror be form real image and larger than the object. So the correct answer is first. Next question is, two metal spheres of same mass are suspended from a common point by a light insulating string. The length of each string is same. The spheres are given electric charge plus Q on one end plus 4Q on another. Which of the given diagram best shows the resulting position of sphere? So in this question we know that if there are two charges plus Q and let's suppose the other charges is plus 4Q, and we know that two charge apply equal and opposite force to each other. So this will repel this charge by Fe, and this will also be repelled by the second charge Fe. So the electrostatic force will be equal. So if there is a string, then equal and opposite forces will be applied. So the best position is theta. So it is plus Q and it is 4Q. Here is electrostatic force Fe and here is also electrostatic force Fe. So the correct option is best representation second. The next question is, in the following figure, the ratio of resistance of block A and block B. And in this question is given that the both block are made by the same material. So we know the formula of resistance, R equal to rho L by A, where L is the length and A is the cross-sectional area. Now for block A, per area will be equal to, we have to consider the perpendicular area, and perpendicular area is T cross A, and length L is A. So resistance of RA will be rho A divided by T cross A. It is equation first. Now for the second block B, RB rho, and the length for the second block is 2A, and the area is, the width is T and height is 2A. So the area will be T into 2A. So the total length 2A and area will be T into 2A. It will rho into A divided by T into A. Second option. And in this question we have to find the ratio of RA and RB. Now from equation, RA and RB will be equal to rho A and T A. it is also a T and rho, it will be equal to 1. So the correct option is second is the correct answer, the ratio will be 1. Next question, in the given circuit, the current in the 2 ohm resistor, the circuit is given, here is 1 by 3 of 10 volt and 1 resistance 5 ohm. It is 10 ohm and here is second battery 20 volt and 2 ohm. Now, in this question, we have to find the current in 2 ohm resistance. Let's suppose if this battery provides current I1 and this second battery of 20 volts gives 20 volt. Now, for the battery 1 or 10 volt, the current should be came I1 and for the second battery I2. Let's suppose it is a node A and it is a node B. If some current goes to in 2 ohm resistance from I1, then there will be no path to come back for the 10 volt battery. So here will be current from this side will be 0. Now for the second battery, if here is a node B, let's suppose some part comes in 2 ohm resistance, then there will be no path to coming back the current to the 20 volt. So here the current by the 20 volt will be also 0. So the net current in 2 ohm resistance, I in 2 ohm resistance will be 0. So the correct answer is option 2 is current. Option 2 is correct. The current in 2 ohm resistance will be 0. The next question is resultant resistance of the circuit is. So we have to find the resultant circuit. First we will here is our A, B. The resistance are given R, R, R and R. Now we can draw the simple form of the circuit. If we draw the simple form, then it will be R and it will be R R R R and R. This side is V and this side is A. So these two resistances are in series, so that it will be formed 2R resistance. And these resistance are in series, these will form resistance of 2R. So the we can replace the circuit. It 2R, 2R and 2R. This is B terminal and this is A terminal. Now from the diagram it is clear that all three resistance in parallel. So R equivalent 1 upon R equivalent will be 1 upon 2R plus 1 upon R plus 1 upon 2R. So it will be 2 divided by 2R plus 1 by R. And R equivalent will be, it will be 2 by R. So the R equivalent will be R by 2. So the correct answer is R by 2. The next question is the total current supplied to the circuit by the battery. So the circuit is given, here is 2 ohm resistance, 6 ohm resistance and 1.5 ohm resistance it is 3 ohm resistance and it is connected here, and it is connected here, and it is connected by 6 volt battery. It is 2 ohm, it is 6 ohm, and it is 3 ohm. Now, if we see the connection of 2 ohm and 6 ohm, then the terminal of 2 ohm resistance and 6 ohm resistance are connected to each other. So, 2 ohm and 6 ohm, these resistance in parallel, and 1.5 ohm is in series with respect to combination of 2 ohm and 6 ohm. So, we can draw the simple form of the circuit. The equivalent resistance of these 2 and 6 ohm will be 2 into 6 divided by 2 plus 6. It will be 12 divided by 8, or we can say it will be 3 by 2. Now, the simplest form of this circuit will be this resistance 3 by 2 and this resistance 3 by 2 and this 3 ohm and this battery is 6 volt. Now, we have to find the current given by the battery. So, these resistance are in series, and the series combination of these resistance with 3 ohm is in parallel. So, the net equivalent resistance, or we can form, draw the another diagram. It is 6 volt. Now, the equivalent resistance of these 3 ohm resistance will be, R equivalent will be 3 by 2 and 1.5 ohm. So, the total current given by battery will be B upon R equivalent. B is given 6 volt and it is resistance is 1.5 ohm. It will be 60 and 4 ampere. So, the current is 4 ampere. So, option third is correct. The next question is, a current of 2 ampere flow in system of resistance shown in figure, the potential difference BA and BB will be. So, first we will draw the diagram circuit 3 ohm. This resistance 3 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm and 2 ohm. Students, in this diagram, if we consider this branch, this branch of 2 ohm and 3 ohm, then the equivalent resistance of these 2 and 3 will be 5 ohm, because 2 ohm and 3 ohm are in series. So, these are series connection and the equivalent will be 5 ohm. Now, in second branch, 2, 3 and 2 are also in series. So, the resistance of 3 and 2 ohm will be 5 ohm. This is also in series. So, if we will, these two resistances are equal, so the current will be divided equally in branch first and second. Here will be the current will be 1 ampere and 1 ampere in second branch. Now we have to find the potential difference between BA and BB. Let's suppose if it is common terminal and we write this YC, so we can write the potential of A in form of BC. So it will be BC minus 1 into 2 equal to BA, or we can say BA will be BC minus 2. It is first equation. Now for the 3 ohm resistance, we can write BB equal to BC minus 3. It is second. Now we have to find the potential difference between BA and BB. So BA minus BB will be BC minus 2 minus BC plus 3. So BC will be cancelled and the result is plus 1 volt. So the correct option is second. Second option is correct. Next question is, blue color of sky is due to. It is a theoretical question and we know that the blue color of sky is due to scattering of light. So option is, option first is correct. Next question is, an electric charge in uniform motion produce electric field only, magnetic field only, both electric and magnetic field. And we know if an electric charge in uniform motion, then it produce both electric and magnetic field. So the correct option is third. The next question is, an electron is traveling horizontally towards east. The magnetic field is vertically downward direction, exert a force on the electron along. So first we will draw the direction. This direction is north, south, east and west. Now the electron is traveling horizontally towards east. The electron is moving in this direction. So the current electron is moving in this direction and the current due to electron will move, will flow in west direction. This is, let's suppose the current is I, and we have to find the force on the electron. Now by the right hand rule, let the electron is moving in this direction and the magnetic field is downward direction. So the magnetic field is downward. Now by right hand rule, the force F equal to Q B cross B. So the direction will be come in north direction. According to this rule, the direction will be come in north direction, but the electron is negative charge, so the direction will be in south direction. So the correct option is south. A current flow in a conductor from east to west, the direction of magnetic field at a point above the conductor. Now we will draw the here is the current flow. Let this is east, west and north and south. The current is flowing from east to west and this is the direction of I, and we have to find the magnetic field at a point above the conductor. Let's suppose this is a wire and the current is flowing this direction, so the direction of magnetic field will be in upward direction, or we can say it will be in north direction. So the correct answer is towards north. The next question is, nuclear energy is produced only nuclear fusion and nuclear fission. So the correct option is third. Nuclear energy is produced in both nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. The next question is, the near point of a person is 40 centimeter. Find the power of a lens if he want to do reading at 25 centimeter. So in this question, the near point is given 40 centimeter, and we have to find the power of lens. So we apply the formula of lens, 1 upon F equal to 1 by B minus 1 by U. Now in this question, the person can see the object at 40 centimeter, but the person want to see at 25 centimeter. So if we place the object at 25 centimeter, the image can be formed at 40 centimeter. So U will be minus 25 centimeter and B will be minus ka 40 centimeter. Now 1 by F will be minus 1 by 40 plus 1 by 25. 1 by F minus 25 plus 40 divided by 40 into 25. So it will be 15 into 40 into 25. So 5, 3, 8. Now we have to find the power. So the power is 100 divided by F. So 100 into 3, 8 divided by 25. So 25 is 4 and it is 2. 3 by 2. It will be 1.5 diopter. So the correct answer is 1.5. Option first is correct.